the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. A great night for baseball ahead on the show. It's the Houston Astros and the Boston Red Sox.
And now,
first pitch coming your way next.
2022 Boston Red Sox.
All right, just about ready to go here at Fenway. Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. Tapped out front of the plate. Vasquez to first. One out in the top of the first. Here's Michael Brantley.
The designated hitter, Michael Brantley.
Left-hand batter waits. And there's a foul ball. No score, just getting started, top of the first. That one is blasted. Left field, towards the monster. Banks off the wall. Fires to second, too late. And he's got a double. And now it's Alex Bregman. Next one misses. Now two balls and a strike. That one in for a strike, 2-2. Next pitch misses. Counts full, 3-2. Got him looked in. Two down. Now it's Yordan Alvarez.
The left fielder, number 44, Yordan Alvarez.
Next pitch is outside. Ground ball to the right side. Dahlbeck steps on the bag. And that is the third out of the inning. Back inside Fenway Park. Now batting Jarren Duran. The wide to kick the pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And one away. And here is Devers. Devers, the baby-faced assassin. Left-hand hitter waits. Big swing and a miss. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Here's Xander Bogaerts.
Not shortstop. Xander.
Kicks and fires. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Gurriel handles the chance. Bogaerts retire. That is the inning. Back now at Fenway. Second inning set to go. Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit. Fouled off. He was late. Hot shot to third. The throw to first, and quickly one away in the second. Kyle Tucker up next for the Astros.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
Next pitch misses inside. 2-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. Second inning here, no score. Line drive, caught. Now it's Jason Castro.
Batting seven, the catcher, Jason Castro.
That one pushed foul. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that is that. Back here in Boston. And now here's the veteran DH, JD Martinez. Talking about Martinez, he's one of the best fastball hitters in the game.
Yeah, some guys are concerned about velocity, but he embraces it.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Hard ground ball, base knock. Here's Alex Verdugo.
Batting fifth. No left fielder.
Alex. The pitch.
Verdugo.
I got 2-1 on the count.
Foul ball. Bounce to the right. Beats the second. Out there. Out with the pitcher covering. It's a 3-6-1 double play.
Batting fifth.
Two outs. Base is empty. Still stepping in for Boston. Christian Vasquez. Two down. Nobody on. Right side. Tucker has a beat on it. Squeezes it. And that's the inning. Back in Boston, and now Chaz McCormick. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Next pitch downstairs. Two balls, two strikes.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Next offering is in for a strike. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. That's out number two. Jose Altuve up to hit here.
The second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Kicks and deals. Next offering is outside. Pitch.
Three.
Right through there. Got it. Out number three. Back here at Fenway Park, bottom of the inning, and stepping in for Boston, Bobby Dalbec. The 1-1. Line drive, and there's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning. Here's Trevor Story.
Batting it. The second baseman. Trevor.
Next offering is in for a strike. Next pitch misses way outside.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
Swing and a miss, struck him out, and there's one down. Now it's Franchy Cordero.
The right fielder, Franchy Cordero.
Next offering is down low. Dalbec leads off first with one away. Next offering clips the zone count even at two. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. That's out number two. And here is Jaron Duran. Led off the game with a strikeout.
Duran.
And it is 2-1. Here goes the runner. Swing and a miss. And safe. It's a stolen base. The pitch. 3-2 now. Runner at second, two down. And ball four to aboard.
Well, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make the call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
Righty delivers. In the dirt. On the ground. The throw to first. And Devers is set down. And that is the inning. Start of the fourth. Now it's the DH, Michael Brantley. And a pitch. That's down and in.
Three balls, one strike.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it. Here's Alex Bregman.
Leading off for Houston.
If you're trying to keep the line moving, this is the guy you want at the plate. Such a good hitter. Can also flash some power.
And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss.
Well, the hitter shows the pitcher that he's willing to go after that pitch down in the zone. So perhaps he'll come back to it. Still try to get that ground ball double play.
Story over to second to Dalbec. Double play. Here's Jordan Alvarez. Grounded out his first time.
Jordan Alvarez.
The 2-1. And now the count filled up 3-2. On the ground, right side, Story handles. And the Astros put down in order. Back here at Fenway, bottom four. Now it's the shortstop, Xander Bogaerts. And he deals. And that one fouled off. When you look at Xander, he has all the tools to anchor a World Series lineup.
Yeah, he's one of those rare talents. He's got power at the plate, discipline to go along with it. Oh, and if he gets on, he's got the speed. This guy's a great combo, and he's an RBI machine.
And fouled off. Here comes a pitch. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
No, good solid contact right there. Just a bit out in front of that fastball. Got to try to stay on that backside just a little bit longer and see if you can do some damage.
3-2 on the way. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at-bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Here's the Boston cleanup hitter, J.D. Martinez.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Oh, just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Next pitch is in the dirt. And yeah, that's ball two. a foul ball. He stays alive.
Starting to get some pretty good timing on that breaking ball, but he's going to have to stay ready for a fastball. Don't want to watch one go right by you.
In the air, left side, Alvarez drops steps, heads back on it, puts it away for the out. So up next, Alex Verdugo. One down, base is empty. Good eye right there. Stays alive. Swing and a ball hammered left field, and that one is off the wall. Runner on at first with one gone, and now it's the catcher for the Red Sox, Christian Vasquez. Swing and a ball popped up. That one gets down for a hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out. Here's Bobby Dalbec.
The first baseman, Bobby.
The pitch.
Dalbec.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
One out. Runners at first and second. On the ground to the left. And foul ball. And that'll load the bases. So bases loaded with one away. And stepping in is the speedy Trevor Story. Next offering way off the plate. Now this one's well hit. Way back there. On its way and out of here. Grand slam.
A great job here of staying within himself. You know that if you get a knock, you're going to drive in a couple, so stay focused on that. Well, he does more than just a knock. Hits the grand slam to drive in four. Really good job at the plate.
One out, base is empty. And now, Franchy Cordero. The pitch. Nope. Off the mark there. 2-2. Next pitch in the dirt, and that's ball three. That one the other way, and that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. Not in time. He's safe. The Astros turn to a new arm on the mound, Brian Abreu. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back to the top of the lineup. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Jarren Duran. So now 1-2. Right-handed reliever. Oh, and the zone doesn't get the call. It's 2-2. Next pitch is downstairs. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Now it's Devers at the plate. Two outs and one in scoring position. Ground ball right side. Altuve handles it, gathers, and throws to first. Inning over, although plenty of damage done. Back here at Fenway, now it's Yuli Gurriel. Anything in particular stand out to you as far as moments at Fenway Park?
Wow, you know, it's unfortunate because I remember as an Oakland A's player, we were up in the series against the Red Sox, 2-0. All we needed to do was close out a Saturday night ball game. We went extra innings. The Red Sox won that ball game. And then Sunday, they pushed the series by winning game 4 back to Oakland for game 5. And unfortunately, they won game 5 as well.
Next offering is down low. 2-1. That one missed. That was 2003, and the Red Sox would eventually get their hearts broken by Aaron Boone, but end the curse a year later.
Close pitch there, but you got to forget about that call if you're out on the mound. You can't let it affect you going forward. You've got to get out of the inning first, and then if you want to be frustrated, take it out in the dugout.
Left-hand batter waits. On the ground at first. Could be two. On to Bogarts. Double play, and that'll do it for the inning. And welcome back. Now, here is Xander Bogaerts. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. Bogaerts, who wears that number 2 on his back for his idol, Derek Jeter. Next pitch inside. And the count is even, 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Just missed.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And he walked him.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a full scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Here's a 1-1. Nobody out. Runner at first. Swung on, belted. And it's off the wall. And now runners at the corners. Nobody out. And next for the Red Sox, Alex Verdugo.
No left field.
And a 2-2. And another ball. This one high in the air to left center. Racing makes the catch. Runner tags from third. He's in to score on the sack fly, and it's now a 6-run lead. Here's Christian Vasquez. Next offering is in for a strike. Next pitch is outside.
Well, he might have to look for a different put away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Next offering is foul back. At the belt and finals. Left field, Alvarez settles under this one, makes the grab, and there's two away. Man at first. Still stepping in for Boston, Bobby Dalbec.
The first baseman, Bobby Dalbec.
And meanwhile, that pitch is off the catcher's mitt. It squirts away. Man on second, two down.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Runner leads away at second. Now this one is smoked down the left field line. On its way, if it's fair, out of here.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
So a new pitcher out of the bullpen for the Astros, Ryan Stanek. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is. Here's Trevor Story now. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Back here in Boston. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Chaz McCormick.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
To first, and a quick out number one.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And a count one and two. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. On the ground, Story gloves it, whips it to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough, got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Foul off down the right side. That one misses, and it's two and two. Now he breaks his bat. On the run, throw to first, and that is that. Well, we go bottom six, and now the right fielder, Franchi Cordero.
So, Boog, you went to college in this town. What was it like for you being a college student and having the opportunity to bounce over here to Fenway Park and see some games?
Yeah, in fact, 1990, a couple of college classmates and I, we were in college. We bought standing room tickets, and then the next night got a chance to see the Red Sox clinch the East against the White Sox in that sliding catch in the corner by Tom Brodansky. The Red Sox would end up losing to the Oakland A's in the playoffs, but that's one of the things that I'll think about in terms of memories from going to college and going to Fenway. And now it's one and two. Stays alive. And the pitch. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
The next pitch misses, and the count's full.
Tough take right there. He swings at that more often than not.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Speaking of walks, did you see anything special during your walk into the ballpark today? I know you like to take in all the surroundings.
I just love interacting with the people. It's just fun to connect. I mean, as I was headed up to the booth, one guy shouted at me, "Make sure to say hi to Kenny." And a pitch. And Devers hits that one. McCormick gliding back. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. Two away. And now Xander Bogaerts. He's already homered here in this one.
Shortstop. Xander Bogaerts.
And here it comes. And now the count is even. Base knock center field. And that'll put runners at the corners with two away. And here is J.D. Martinez.
J.D. Martinez.
And the next pitch is way outside. Two and one to J.D. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And down on strikes he goes. Third out. And we're back here at Fenway Park. We go to the top of the seventh. Michael Brantley to start things off. 1-2 now. This ball's chopped on the ground. Over to Dalbec. That's the first out, the top of the seventh. Now it's Alex Bregman.
Now batter, third baseman, Alex Bregman.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. So, man aboard. Now here is Yordan Alvarez.
Yordan Alvarez.
The 1-1. And that one just missed off the outside edge. Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away. John Schreiber gets handed the rock out of the pen, and he'll try to keep this big lead right where it is. Here's Gurriel. And a pitch. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Bregman around third. He's in there. So first and second with one man gone. Here's Kyle Tucker.
The right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
And down on strikes. Two away now. And stepping in for the Astros, Jason Castro. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. So two down now, and here is Chaz McCormick. And the righty deals. That clips the corner. Popped up. And that one actually will be grabbed by Story, and that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark, here's the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. Here's a 1-2.
No.
On the ground, right side. In time to Gurriel. And the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh. Now Christian Vasquez catcher. Up next for the Red Sox. One for three. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it. And here's the first baseman, Bobby Dalbec.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely. Try to hit the ball out of the park. Do what he loves to do.
Swings and misses. And the count 1-2.
Well, two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Next offering down low and in the dirt. Kicks and fires. The punch out there. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Back inside Fenway Park, and here is Jeremy Peña. The pitch. Right field, down the line, and that one slices down. Here's a 1-2. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. One out. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
The second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Righty delivers.
Count to two and one.
That one fouled off, 2-2. The pitch. That one fouled off. Next one off the plate inside, and it's 3-2. Kicks and deals. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That's back there. Feeling for the wall as he makes the catch.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
3-2 now. Ground ball left side. Devers throws on to first. And that is that. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Blake Taylor. And we'll see how he performs in this situation with his team down big. Back here in Boston, bottom of the eighth. Here's a speed threat, Trevor Story. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But, yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
And it finds its way through for a hit. Man at first. Now it's the right fielder, Franchi Cordero.
16. Franchi Cordero.
And a pitch. Swings and misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One gone to the bottom of the eighth.
Now
here's the center fielder, Jaren Duran.
Duran.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hand, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
Check swing, now an appeal to third, and he held back, according to Larry Bullard.
Oh, good day for the on-base percentage right there. Walk number three, and the free bags keep on coming. You got an OBP booth.
And now the lefty swings and lines a base hit into left field. And they stop him at third, so bases loaded with one away. One out, bases loaded. Xander Bogaerts up next for the Red Sox.
Bogaerts.
Two-two. And a foul ball, he stays alive. All loaded up, all Red Sox in this one. Swings here and blasts one left field. And it's off the wall. On to third, save, as they score a pair on the play. So they're at the corners now. Here is J.D. Martinez. And a 1-1. And that's down and away. Two on, one out. Still only one out here in the inning. Tap softly to the right side. Castro sends it to first. There for the out. Runner scores from third. Hector Neris taking over on the mound. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there. And stepping in for Boston, Alex Verdugo. Swings and misses. Good job of damage control right there. Back now at Fenway. All set for the start of the inning. And stepping in for the Astros, Alex Bregman. Next offering is downstairs.
Two balls, one strike.
That one ripped right center field on its way. And that one is gone. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Yordan Alvarez. The 1-1. Out towards right center. That's well struck. Gone! Left-hander out of the bullpen, Max Strom. And a healthy-sized lead for him to go to work with. So next up for Houston, Yuli Gurriel. Center field. Durant makes the grab. One down. Kyle Tucker getting now ready to hit. A strikeout right and a walk.
Kyle Tucker.
And that's ball four.
Nope.
Jason Castro digs in now.
The catcher, Jason Castro.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And there's two now away. And next to hit for Houston, Chaz McCormick.
McCormick.
Hit hard, should be extra bases. Tucker around third. He will score, and they're on the board, but lots of ground to make up. And the batter will be the shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
Shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
Next offering is fouled back. Next one misses, and that's ball two. Just one strike away. Little dribbler up along third, and he grabs it in foul ground. Down to their final strike. Just outside. And the count's full.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Just one out away, try to close it out. Tap to first. Steps on the bag himself. Ball game.
Offensive explosion today for these guys. They gave up a few runs, but they have more than enough firepower to turn this one into a blowout.
Final score in this one, 11-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Schomburg. Thanks for joining us.
The final line score for our ball game tonight: for the victorious Boston Red Sox, 11 runs, 13 hits, no errors. They left six men on base.